ఆదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశర్షభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పెరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. షల్ వి బిగిన్ శ్రీమద్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 35 ఇన్ 6th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ అసంశయం మహాబాహో మనో దుర్నిగ్రహం చలం అభ్యాసేన తు కౌంతేయ వైరాగ్యేణ చ గృహ్యతే. భగవాన్ కృష్ణ అప్ టు వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 32 టాట్ ద ధ్యాన యోగం అండ్ దాట్ ఆల్సో ఇన్ ఫోర్ ఫోల్డ్ వే. ఫస్ట్ హీ బిగన్ విత్ బాహ్య సాధనాని, జనరల్ డిసిప్లిన్ ఫార్ మెడిటేషన్. Then he also continued as antaranga sadhanani, immediate disciplines to be observed. The means, immediate means. Desaha, kalaha, asanam, sharira sthiti, prana samyam, then indriya nigraha, mano nigraha, buddhi nishchayaha. So this kind of all antaranga sadhanani. Then also he brought all the portion of dhyana swarupam as dharana, dhyanam, samadhi. Then afterwards he taught the fruits of this meditation. Now, after completing everything, Arjuna set a question. That which is the great obstruction for the meditation. Then not even the obstructions are there outside. He says the obstruction which is in the mind alone, mind becomes obstruction. So how can this mind becomes an obstruction for this knowledge? Because when you study Bhagavad Gita or any Shastra, you need to have ekagrata chittam. As Patanjali says, modham, kshiptam, vikshiptam, ekagram, niruddham. There are five kinds of mind. Modham means completely deluded. The person cannot understand even Shastra a little bit. Kshiptam means that is always fluctuated. It's completely wavered mind. The mind which is turbulent, and also the mind which doesn't allow the person to sit in a place. Vikshiptam means now and then fluctuated mind and now and then with ekagrata chittam. Ekagra means completely focused, concentrated. Niruddham means completely restrained. That's what known as samadhi. Now Arjuna says, my mind is not modham, kshiptam, even vikshiptam. Though I get ekagrata chitta, but I am not able to get niruddha chittam. That is one meaning, because Arjuna was a very trained warrior. His mind, though for the time being it is not stable, but he knows what the mind of ekagrata chittam. Sarvaloka prasiddhatvena tadeva chanchalatvam upapadayati. Arjuna asked for, in general, in all psychological level, the people are fluctuated. They are very difficult because I am not the Uttama Adhikari. I am a Madhyama Adhikari. Madhyama Adhikari means what? A person who is an intermediate. He is not in the beginning preliminary student. He is not even higher student, Now he himself accepts as though, yes, I am an intermediate student. Therefore, I am asking that once I learnt a jnanam, then after even learning the jnanam, that I am not able to set myself, because mind becomes a valid, a powerful, an obstruction in order to set me or set me in the knowledge. Chanchalam atyartham chalam sada chalana swabhavam manaha. The mind has the tendency to jump one object to another object, that is the tendency. Now here he brings the mind even not allowing my indriya to be endowed with peace. It says pramathi, indriyanam pramathi, means it disturbs like anything. All the indriyas are burnt by mind. Mind is not allowing sit in a place. Tasya aham nigraham manye. It's, you know, very difficult to catch a wind. He gives the best example. The Bhashyakara gives lots of the explanation about why he selects this example. Aham nigraham manye. Then Krishna immediately says, asamshayam mahabhagho manaha achalam durnigraham chalam. The mind is like that. The creation of mind itself is like that alone. So he makes the bhava. The meaning is, jatepi tatvajnane prarabdha karma bhogaya jivataha purushasya kartratva bhoktratva sukha dukha raga dveshadi lakshanas chitta dharmaha klesha hetatvad badhitan anuvrityapi bandhaha bhavati chitta vritti nirodha rupena tu yogena tasya nivaranam jivan muktihi iti uchyati. So very clearly he makes Krishna understand, oh Krishna, see, you are giving the boon, nectar, but I could not assimilate it. I am not able to get the samadhi. Samadhi means become one with the knowledge. There where I am finding difficult. In simple way, I am not able to digest it. I am not able to convert into a direct knowledge. The knowledge exists in indirect knowledge way. Then Bhagavan Krishna brings the solution. Obstruction was introduced by Arjuna. Now the solutions, there are two kinds of upayas. Dve upayav, two kinds of upayas are introduced, abhyasa and yoga. This abhyasa means what? Shravana, manana, nididhyasana. Then the continuing with nididhyasana. So nididhyasanam is to restrain, to get the niruddhavastha. You first understand Vedanta study means shravanam. Shravanam means to observe, to receive the knowledge from the guru. And all these people say, acharyas say, shravanam should take place. That shravanam means direct meaning, literal meaning to hear. Shravanam here, which is pointed out, it's not to hear, not to just hear. So in order to hear, you need to have hear and some there must be some sound. No, here there are so many circumstances should be together, like making a chemistry. That chemistry, setting a chemistry with acharya, setting a chemistry with shastra. If you have proper chemistry with acharya, no, nowadays this word is very important. So if when two people are acting, the chemistry should work out. In the same way, when two people are marrying, their chemistry should work out. And when two people are doing business or they are making some decision, there must be the chemistry. That chemistry should be brought in the first place in the relationship with Guru. That has to be proper. Therefore, we call it sahana vavatu, sahana bhunaktu, sahavirya karavavahai. So many times I tell you this mantra because it's very important. So Sahana Avatu, God may protect both of us in order to set the proper chemistry. Because my prarabdha vasha, the student is suffering from his prarabdha, but Guru, who is completely free person, now that free person should have a karuna, compassion towards the person who suffers. If he doesn't have the compassion, he cannot be a guru, he cannot teach him. Though he brings the compassion, but Shishya, if his prarabdha karma, means the karma phala, is not allowing to receive it, no chemistry will work out. Therefore, the student always should be endowed with japa, tapa, so many vratas in order to set a proper chemistry with the guru. Guru Bhakti is the great in all history, it is said in Puranas, in so many places, that Guru Bhakti will bring the proper chemistry. When you have the proper chemistry with the Guru, that will bring the chemistry with the Shastra. So, though you have the chemistry, but you are not able to set yourself with the Shastra, means so useless. You may get Punya Pala by serving the Guru, but the Shastra brings the knowledge. When you are able to set the chemistry, for that you need to have the Guru's connection. So once you are able to set the chemistry with the Shastra, then the Ishvara can be connected with. Then you can set the chemistry with Ishvara. All together, if it works, you will gain knowledge. Okay? So all this process is known as a Shravanam. Once you receive the knowledge completely, the Shravanam is done. That Shravanam, after the Shravanam, also there are doubts, is possible. That doubts won't allow you to sit with the knowledge. Though Shravanam took place, but you are not okay with that, means there are so many doubts, the mind won't allow to observe it. It becomes the obstruction. So once there are obstructions, you cannot go ahead. Therefore, during the Shravanam alone, you should have the interaction with the Guru. Acharyat padam adatte padam shishyasvam edhayam. So when teacher teaches, so only you could receive 25% of teaching. That is the capacity of the human being. If you are a ekachanda grahi, what is this ekachanda grahi? So once you hear from the Guru, you will get great understanding what to be understood. So those people were there in the Puranic time. Now is very rare because we are out focusing people, extroverted people. Because of media, technology and so much of information technology around us, the whole world in our hand, in the form of mobile, you can get connected whatever the part in the world you want to get to. Therefore, it's very difficult. It has become, because the mind and body, it has been grossified everything. But when you are sticking with vratas, parayanam, japa and so many tapas, so willfully making your body into heating, burning vratas. Now we are focused alone, not on the Atmajnana. We are very sharp-minded people towards out, extrovert. Therefore, the mind becomes a great obstruction. The mind which endowed with doubt. Therefore, now Krishna, in between, he gets the questions, immediately he asks. That part is known as mananam. Mananam means not to repeat merely. Mananam means it is getting clarity and getting solved all the doubts. So once you have become doubtless person, still the knowledge can be sitting inside as though indirect knowledge, the knowledge which is not assimilated. Then you need to have nididhyasana part. For that nididhyasana part, because of out focusing nature, the mind which has that out focusing nature must be changed completely, and that has to be driven the attention towards inside. Now it's very difficult job. That's what Arjuna's question meant for. He asked, I'm not able to draw my attention from outside world to inside, whatever the knowledge you brought. Then Krishna brought two solutions. Abhyasa Vairagyena. Abhyasa means, there are so many meanings. Abhyasa means continuous practice. That we will see later. First, Vairagya. Vairagya. Vairagya means what? Vigata ragaha. Virakta bhavaha. Not being pulled by outside world. Not being fluctuated by our own indriyas. Not being deviated by so many pursuits outside. The person who is clear with the goal, the mind which is endowed with viveka, distinguishing capacity. The mind which is finely tuned with satyam, asatyam knowledge. Nitya nitya vastu vivekaha. The mind which could understand the reality of the world. First, the viveka to be brought. Okay? The viveka to be brought. Why? Viveka means, so what is nityam, what is anityam? The anityatvam of the world must be understood first. The body to be understood. The body has the limitation. The body will perish in a day. The world also, all the enjoyments are changing. The world is not eternal. This is non-eternal. All the enjoyments, they are seemingly like shadow, like a mirage water. They are not endowed with what I need. The way, the importance which I give to the world, because I believe world can give what I need. I need complete satisfaction. I think world can give that. No, world cannot give it. By having dosha darshanam, again and again, and seeing the limitation of the entire world, that non-eternity, people are there, half an hour before there was a person, now he is not. People are no more, no age limit. So whenever harati nimeshat kala sarvam, it is non-eternal. World, the life is like, you know, it's a flicker of the moment. We don't know when it is going to be last breath. And whatever the achievement people achieve, after the achievement, still they are dissatisfied. Death comes, may take place at any point of time. So all this kind of thinking and bringing the distinguishing capacity, viveka, then that viveka will bring vairagya. Once you learned the world is asatyam, mithya, mithya means false. False in the sense, the experience of the world which I confirm, the world is beautiful, false. World is painful, hell, false. Both of them are false. So I become very thorough in that. For that I need to have a clear observation about experiences and the incidents which happens to me, the incidents or accident which happens to others. For that we have to study lots of Puranas. Hiranyakashipu was there and he is no more. Narakasura was there, he is no more. Ravaneshwara was there, no more. So many people were there, no more. All people who were taken into the Sharira, even Prahlada was there. So many rishis, even they are not there. Whoever comes, they have to go. Even Krishna was, you know, killed by somebody. That is the normal phenomenon of the nature of the world. That Vivekatvam to be brought. There is one entity called Atma, and that which is non-perishable, all-pervasive, by knowing which I will get moksha. I will get moksha, that is what is nothing but complete satisfaction. This is what known as Vairagya. Once you get this kind of realization in your mind, the mind won't be taken for a ride. The mind which won't set a wavering attitude. The mind which cannot become turbulent. Therefore, we need to set Vairagya. Vairagya means the mind which cannot be attractive, pulled towards outside world. That's what Krishna is bringing. There are two solutions. Is Vairagya is the best way. Once you get the Vairagya, again and again, Abhyasa means practice, continuous practice. Now he himself will explain what is Abhyasa and Vairagya. Let us continue.
Asam yatatmana yogah dushprapa iti me matihi vasyatmana tu yatata sakyo vaptumapayatah.
He says, asam shayatmana yogah. It is the yoga which to be brought in you, the way the discipline brought in you. And that yogaha means nididhyasanam, which is backed by shravanam mananam, that has to be doubtless. And that has to be focused enough. Samyatatma means the person who is endowed with complete focused mind. Okay. And this vairagya, the mind which is endowed with vairagya, Acharya beautiful says, drishta drishta bhogeshu dosha darshana abhyasat vaitrushnyam tena cha vairagyena grihyate. The mind which is endowed with fluctuation, called vikshepa rupaha pracharaschittasya evam tanmanaha grihyate. The mind is endowed with fluctuation because that is the nature. So vairagya means by having dosha drishti, again and again practicing vairagya, you can bring to samyama. Samyama means ekagrata chitta. If you are not bringing samyama, means complete focus and non-fluctuated state, yoga won't be available. It will become very difficult for you. That's what my opinion.
Vashyatmana tu yatata shakyaha avaptum upayataha.
Though the mind doesn't have the capacity to become concentrated, but abhyasa vairagya, slowly, without any intervenient or intervals, continuous practice will make definitely the mind to set or get settled with knowledge, no doubt in it. Then Arjuna brings another question, because this portion is very important for us, because we are not ekachanda grahi. We have fluctuated mind, wavered mind, turbulent mind. We suffer because of our own psychological system. This is the solutions after learning all this Upanishad. This solution we need, it's very much important. Arjuna's questions will help us to dwell more. We will continue tomorrow in the next episode. I'll see you. Harihi Om.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. ओम शांति 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 ही हरि ही ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ही ओम